Now, I'm gonna teach you models. Before that, I have to tell about auxiliaries or helping verbs. Auxiliaries or helping verbs are divided into two types: primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Primary auxiliaries are divided into three types: B, to, and have. B is again subdivided into eight categories or eight types, you can say, that is am, is, are, was, where, be, been, being. Do into three, that is two does did. Have into three, that is have, has, had. Altogether, 14, that is 8 plus 3 plus 3 is equal to 14 primary auxiliaries. Then comes modals. 13 in number. Can, could, shall, should, will, would, may, might, must, ought to, used to, need, dare. These days, some modern grammarians have added three other verbs as modal verbs, that is, be able to, that is, am able to, is to, able to, are able to. Number two, had better. Number three, comes your have to. Again, one more information I have to give you, that modal auxiliaries is subdivided into two categories, that is pure modals and semi-modals or marginal modals. Your pure modals are 9 in number, that is can, could, shall, should, will, would, may, might, and must. Then come to semi-modals or marginal modals, that is used to, ought to, dare, need, etc. Now, I will tell about something very special on shall and will, because I have heard many times many students say that after I we use shall not will. Some students say that we use I will not I shall. So let us have a clarification on your shall and will. Shall in the first person simply tells, in will a promise dwells. Shall in the second third does threat, will then tells a future fit. If you use shall after I, it refers to simple future. I'm telling a beautiful anecdote. Somebody told someone, I'll give you 100 rupees. I shall give you 100 rupees, and he didn't pay. After 1 month, the person who had to get that 100 rupees went to the court and filed a suit against him. On the day of judgment, the judge asked, please say which model the man has used. The advocate said, shall. So fine him 10 rupees. Another case came to that court on the same matter, that is, someone has said, I will give you 100 rupees. The judge asked the advocate, please tell me the model. The advocate said, will, I will give you 100 rupees. So the judge fined him 20 rupees. One question is there, I dash go whatever happens, within bracket, shall will. It refers to determinations for me, so I will go whatever happens, I will go even if it rains. Similarly, let us come to you. You dash go whatever happens, shall will, you shall go whatever happens. In the film Bathing Beauty, Esther Williams has captivated millions of audience by telling that two lines: I shall take the high road and you shall take the low. I shall take the high road and you shall take the road. So after I, when you use shall, it refers to simple futurity. And if you use shall after you, it refers to promise, determination, or threats. So you just hear this video several times. So what will happen? You will remember so many things and have a good practice it. After that, I will give some written materials in terms of exercise, etc. You will do. In case of doubt, let us have it clarified by me. Ask me without having a doubt, fear, or apprehension. Thank you all.